ब्यूटीफुल कर गई चुल।
Hello, welcome to tonight's episode of Emerging Voices Season 2. We have a very exciting episode in store for you tonight. You're not going to want to miss a minute of it. Tonight is the People's Choice Round, where the contestants will be singing songs that are popular right here in Guyana. 18 contestants have started this remarkable journey, only 6 remain. As you can remember, contestants are eliminated based on the number of likes that they get from our judges. So let's bring the first contestant up on stage. I want to tell you a little bit about this first.
What's up?
Gentlemen, Mr. Nepal Chitlal. What's happening, buddy?
Thank you, Jared.
And
hi.
What are you doing here?
Well, I came to entertain, and all, I believe that I will also be joining the esteemed panel this
evening.
You're
going to be a judge?
That's right.
I was going through my little monologue, and I saw all the women in the room just start smiling immediately, and I was like, damn, I do look kind of good. Aww. And then you appear behind me and just dash my hopes. Taruna hasn't stopped smiling since you came out. Seriously, her mouth hurts right now.
That's the effect of music. It ain't me. It's the music.
It's the music. I love the song. That was awesome.
It's a beautiful
bro.
Song.
Nice.
What are you expecting from our contestants tonight?
Well, I was hearing some of the contestants rehearsing earlier, and I was totally blown away.
Okay.
Not just by their ability to do technical things, but the place that they sing from. It's such a sincere place. It's an honest place. It's a place that touches me, and that is of paramount importance to me when I'm listening to a singer. I want that person to first of all move me, make me feel something. And they definitely are doing a good job at that.
So tell me something, is this the first time you're hearing about Emerging Voices?
It is not the first time I've heard about Emerging Voices, but it's my first time being here and being present in this magnificent energy and vibration and love and music from the people of Guyana.
Well, Naval, tell me something. How important do you think it is for shows like this to kind of, you know, pick talent out of the far reaches of a country? I mean, does this happen in Trinidad?
It sure does. In fact, I am a product of talent shows.
Fantastic.
And, you know, as a musician or somebody aspiring to be a musician, you got to battle with a lot of voices. Not only the external voices that tell you you can't do something.
You guys paying attention to this.
But your internal voices, those voices that tell you you ain't good enough, you won't ever make it. Nobody want to listen to you. So you gotta battle those external and internal voices. And to have a forum like this for talent to come and showcase itself, not just in a way that doesn't bring out the best in them, because even the talent shows in Trinidad and Tobago, they don't match this level of production that I'm seeing here in Guyana. You have to give yourselves a huge round of applause for that. This forum and this level of production is not present, I don't think, anywhere in the region, in the Caribbean region.
That's a huge compliment coming from you.
Are doing such a fantastic job on fostering great talent and nurturing it. And this is what we need to do, and to bring the voices of Guyana and to have them emerge and take center stage.
Mr. Naval Chetlal, direct from Trinidad and Tobago, ladies and gentlemen. Taruna, you know when the show starts like that, the rest of the episode is just gonna be epic. Now, tonight is the People's Choice episode, so there's a very good chance that I might actually know some of the songs they're going to be singing.
I think so.
Yeah, I can't wait for the action to start. You know what? Let's bring the first contestant up on stage.
Who
do we got, Taruna?
And our first contestant is Dharmraj, and he will be performing Gerwa.
Dharmraj.
हम गया आसमां पिघल के शीशे में ढल के जम गया तो तेरा चेहरा बन गया दुनिया बुला के तुमसे मिला हूं निकली है दिल से ये दुआ संभल के दर्द का वो सारा चेहरा बन गया दुनिया बुला के तुमसे मिला हूँ निकली है दिल से ये दुआ रंग दे तुम
Raj, awesome performance.
I tried.
I'm going to kick it straight across to the judges. First, our esteemed guest judge from Trinidad.
Dharam Raj. Yeah?
Yeah.
You definitely have a beautiful instrument. There's an attractive quality to your voice that draws us in when we listen to you. Technically, I don't think you have that kind of... support under you, diaphragmatic support, breathing support, because there are many beautiful lines to be sung, and not just be sung, but held in this song, right? And the song requires that you traverse different octaves. And there are a lot of, you know, singing in the different subtucks. And you need some more flexibility and control of breath to do those things. There are many exercises that can be prescribed to do such things and to do them comfortably. And I feel like when you're going up into the top registers also, your voice becomes compressed. Again, it's because you're not singing from a supported position with the diaphragm. Okay. I don't know if you're understanding what I'm saying. I don't know if you had any formal training at all.
No, I haven't trained really.
How long have you been singing?
I've learned some stuff.
Right.
From Purnaj and Jeff and...
Right. On the competition itself, they've been grooming you.
Yeah, yeah. I have learned some other stuff, you know, some
right.
little...
So there are a lot of issues that I'm hearing in your singing, and there are things that you can do to fix those. And my little advice to you is to just start basic exercises, holding one note for a duration of time. And then trying to extend that duration more and more and more so that you can have more control of breath.
Okay.
Yeah?
The cool thing about exercise is they just don't fix one song. Not only Gerua gets fixed, everything gets fixed.
Oh.
What you need to start to get used to is learn how to sing soft. You only have soft and you have super loud. You have to work on the middle ranges. Oh. But other than that, you have a lot of energy. And so far, like I told you, you've been safe. You've been singing songs that are like much faster and it's... You don't have to hold many long notes. This is one of the first songs he's actually holding longer notes. You know, so this is going to be one of your challenges. All right, but keep it up.
Thanks.
Good job. Thank
you. This song is very, very sweet. It has that kind of romantic touch to it that just has to hit you. And for me, it didn't hit me throughout the song. I think the signature of the song is the beginning of the song, Dhoop Se Nikal. I mean, right away, that should hold you, grab you, and just keep you. And you have a powerful voice. There are things that you do with it that I think are different from a lot of the other participants. But I think you just have to know how to wield the power that is your voice. And it just comes down to listening more to music, taking your time with the notes, and singing it slowly so that every note is enunciated. And you punctuate well. But, I mean, overall, it was an okay performance. But for me, it wasn't Gerua enough.
I'm going to have to give you some credit because you went out of your comfort zone with this song. Every other song you've sang has been a Sukhvinder-type song. It's been a song where you have to throw and you have to have that energy. This is the first time you've done something super soft and romantic. And I could tell you're not used to it. But one thing I'm going to give you credit for is right before you got on the stage, you were singing it one way. And then when we started it, even though I gave you just a few seconds of input on how to elongate your note a little bit, don't cut them off right away. Have a tail at the end. Let them have a transition. Let them taper. When you heard that, you were able to pick up on it. Now, you weren't 100%, but you certainly tried, and I could see the effort, and I heard the difference. So I'm proud of you for trying something that's completely out of your comfort zone, and I have a feeling that you're going to continue to do better. Yeah?
Yeah.
Keep working hard, my man.
Yeah.
Well, Dharmraj, that was a great performance tonight. I hope you take the judges' advice.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
And you roll with that. I hope you guys are listening, paying attention to what the judges are saying about your competitors. Emerging Voices Season 2 will be right back.
Hold on. I found our colors.
Torgonal's state-of-the-art color matching system accurately matches any color sample you need to your satisfaction, making your color choices unlimited.
We finally made our decision.
Great, let's get started.
Something else.
Visit Torgonal at 118 Regent and Alexander Streets or 21 Regent and Hing Streets.
Celebrate life, celebrate taste, enjoy the flavor, no time to waste. Enjoy the way it rolls on your tongue, enjoy the smooth way it goes down. I seal it with joy, celebrate and enjoy.
14 flavors to quench your thirst when you feel the heat reach. Ginger and banana, tangerine, bubblegum, orange and cream soda, mango, green, crush fruit, butter and pear, grapefruit, passion fruit, lets you know it's time to celebrate. I see. Celebrate and enjoy.
Boasting 24-karat gold and the finest handmade crafts, King's Jewelry World remains Guyana's top jeweler, attracting interest from all over the world.
As you know, the quality of gold in Guyana is very high. The availability, the abundance of gold has made it an excellent opportunity to share with the rest of the world. Our craftsmen have been using the same techniques that they would have brought centuries ago. And it's the love and the handmade aspect of the jewelry that we have that makes it stand out from the rest of the world.
The desire to create a product that not only leaves an impression, but which tells a story is the very quality that distinguishes King's Jewelry World as the premier choice. Be a part of something great.
Welcome to Guyana, and I encourage you to visit King's Jewelry World, manufacturers of Guyana's gold, and be sure to take home a piece of Guyana's gold. World renowned.
King's Jewelry World. Be sure to take home a piece of Guyana's gold.
Hello there. You're looking at the reigning Miss Guyana Talent Team, Risa Sukla. When I'm ready to quench my thirst, I grab a refreshing sunburst.
Our next contestant is Ritesh, and he will be performing O Satire.
O Satire. Satire.
धड़कन में प्यास है तेरी सांसों में तेरी खुशबू है इस धरती से उस अंबर तक मेरी नजर
Scale of 1 to 10, where were you on this one? On 10 saying, let's say 10 is like, you nailed it, this is the best you could have done given the circumstance, and 0 is you're sleeping.
You're putting me in a spot there, actually.
That's right, my man.
I will give myself there out of the 10, as you're actually indicating. I'll put myself within the midst of the 7 there.
Seven. 10 being your best, not like, you know, Sonu Nigam or some super duper singer, right? Yeah, yeah. So 7 out of 10 on yours?
Well, I'm signposting that.
So that's... tell me why did you discount those 3 points?
I can recall vividly when I went into the Antara, and the first verse, the music author coming there, and then I went on to come into the other verse. I don't know if that was the point.
So wait, what happened? The musicians kind of messed up? Is that what you're saying? You messed up.
Right, because I'm supposed Came to wait late. On that line,
okay.
Then get into the next line.
I think
that's the part I recognize very
good,
fairly there.
Good, good. I just wanted to make sure you knew what you did wrong.
Yes, I did.
so that was the biggest thing. Your vocals, it was hard to even get a... See, what happened was as soon as you came in, you were off. So then it took a second for all of us to kind of forget about that and start listening to you. And then, all right, we were like, okay, yeah. Sounding good, he's moving on with it. We can try to forget about that and see how he finishes the song. And then the verse came, and you did it again. And that was when it was just kind of like, one time I can kind of forgive it. The second time, I looked at these guys, and they looked at me, and we kind of just had this silence, and we were just feeling for you, because it was a pretty big blunder.
You came in 4 bars early. And then you missed Dosa Tire after this tie. And that just it just did it for us. I wanted to come up there and strangle you because this would have been a great performance, an amazing performance because your voice is strong, you have the range, and you have the power. It would have been just beautiful. But those two things, oh man, you killed it for me, man. That's it.
I think you have a beautiful heart, and it definitely shines through when you sing, and you give the appearance that you're giving your all. That's important. A lot about singing on a stage is about acting also. No matter how nervous you are or whatever you're feeling inside, you need to present something that will appeal to the public, right? But I feel with that acting came a lot of overacting, and you were disconnected from the lyrics and the text that you were singing. And besides all the technical mishaps and blunders that happened, I think you lost my attention after the first chorus. Then I started paying attention to the band and trying to keep focus on the music because the band was driving you. They're supposed to accompany you and give musical support. You're supposed to take the reins as the artist and as the performer. But that didn't happen. The band was taking away the focus from you because you weren't reining in your your abilities in such a way to engage me and the panel and the audience. Your voice wasn't resonant enough. You weren't projecting enough. You weren't singing with that emotional abandon. Like, you knew what the song meant. You were just robotically doing it. You sound like a robot. And you lost my attention very early in the song, and at one point I felt like telling you to stop, but I couldn't.
I think at the beginning we all just looked at each other when that happened, and we were thinking, oh no, so early and this. Because when it happens this early, it throws them off, you know, and then I was hoping that he would get back into it, and then there again, it comes up again. And I know you are fighting to stay on top of it, but one of the things I want to reiterate is that your voice just works so well with this song. And I think that's something that is your strongest quality. You have such a beautiful voice. And your voice is made for music of perhaps the 70s and 80s, that period, when it was all about soft singing, when it's about soulful singing. And that's a quality that you've brought to this show, actually.
Thanks so much.
Such a beautiful voice.
Two performances down, there's a lot more fun to come, plus a couple of surprises that you don't know about. Emerging Voices Season 2 will be right back.
Hold on, I found our colors.
Turgenal's state-of-the-art color matching system accurately matches any color sample you need to your satisfaction, making your color choices unlimited.
We finally made our decision.
Great, let's get started.
Something else.
Visit Turgenal at 118 Regent and Alexander Streets or 21 Regent and Hing Streets.
Boasting 24-karat gold and the finest handmade crafts, King's Jewelry World remains Guyana's top jeweler, attracting interest from all over the world.
As you know, the quality of gold in Guyana is very high. The availability, the abundance of gold has made it an excellent opportunity to share with the rest of the world. Our craftsmen have been using the same techniques that they would have brought centuries ago. And it's the love and the handmade aspect of the jewelry that we have that makes it stand out from the rest of the world.
The desire to create a product that not only leaves an impression, but which tells a story is the very quality that distinguishes King's Jewelry World as the premier choice. Be a part of something great.
Welcome to Guyana, and I encourage you to visit King's Jewelry World, manufacturers of Guyana's gold, and be sure to take home a piece of Guyana's gold. World renowned.
King's Jewelry World. Be sure to take home a piece of Guyana's gold.
Hello there. You're looking at the reigning Miss Guyana talented team, Risa Sukla. And when I'm ready to quench my thirst, I grab a refreshing sunburst.
Welcome back to Emerging Voices Season 2. You're joining us in our People's Choice Round, where our contestants will be singing songs that are popular right here in Guyana. Taruna, who's the next contestant?
Our next contestant is the charming Shivanan.
Shivanan. Shivanand, nice job out there, bro.
Thank you.
I enjoyed that. I was watching that from backstage. That was good.
Okay, thanks.
I was looking at the judges, and I think for the first time this evening, they sat up. I saw Jeffrey sit up in his chair, and he was, you know, bopping away. They were looking for your intonations, and I think the judges really enjoyed it.
Okay. I would like to hear from them.
I mean, were you watching them? Did you? When you're up here, I just have a question. When you're up here, I mean, do you actually like zone in on the judges and look at them to see if
yes,
they're...
Yes, I always keep an eye on Purnash, Dr. Bindi, and sometimes Jeffrey.
Sometimes Jeffrey. Just sometimes, you know? All right, well, hey, let's hear what the judges
Shivanan, thought. I want to go first, man. Because you... That was such an exciting performance. I want to give you all my likes one time.
Oh, man.
You know, great.
They were so good, I didn't even get a chance to give you likes. I was like on the edge of my seat because you were messing up all these things in rehearsal. And all the things that we were telling you about, I was like, oh man, this guy's hopeless. It's not gonna work out. And you did them all today. And you even did a few variations you snuck in there, man. Good job, buddy. Good job.
Thanks a lot.
Nice job. You know something, Purnash? I told him on the last episode to loosen up a bit and feel himself. And you know what?
So you think this is because of you? So we should give you all the credit,
I'll
yeah?
I'll just take the compliments.
Okay.
Yo, Shiv, I love how you play with the different textures of your voice. I don't know if you're doing this thing consciously or not. Definitely not conscious of it. But
it's coming natural, actually.
Natural.
All right.
Yeah, it comes naturally because sometimes the emotions that you put into the song carries it, you know? It makes you croon, it makes you become breathy, it makes you become more resonant at certain times when you need to have a strong presence. And I feel although you have a nice handle on all of those things, there were certain points where you should have been a little more resonant on certain phrases, and you could have delivered it with more point in the voice. Point meaning more resonance, because sometimes you have this breathy tone like I'm speaking right now while you're singing, right? And if you're gonna sing the entire song like that, it tends to dry the throat out, and I heard you had some issues where you were trying to clear your throat in between, and you were gasping a little bit, because when you have a breathy production, you kind of have an inefficient use of the breath. Yeah, and then the voice is gonna collapse on you sometimes.
Right.
And you want to clear that throat. So you need to look at those things when you're singing and become conscious of it. It's a beautiful thing to do. We want to encourage it, but you have to know when and how to use it. Right, buddy?
Yes, sir. Shivanand, well, I wanted to hear this song because I remember when you sang it the first time, I said, who are you whispering to? I remember that. And I said, do you sing this to your girlfriends like that? And I wanted to hear more. But you know what? You restored my faith in you tonight.
Oh, well done, bro.
You restored my faith in you tonight. I was like coming closer and closer. I moved from here to here.
I saw that.
And you know, there were certain things that you just nailed. And there were certain modulations that you did that I never heard you do like ever before. And I always have been telling you this. You know, one of the things he told me, I said, Shivanand, are you from a family of singers? And he said, no, only my surname is Singh. So I said, you know, then you've just been blessed with that kind of a voice that makes you sit up and take notice. You know, so you know what? Develop it. Use it. It's raw, it's rare, and it's real. And you got it. So make the best use of it.
Thank you. Mr. Jeffrey.
I don't really have much to add. I just, I'm shocked. I'm super duper shocked. I was not expecting, well, you woke me up, number one. I was kind of bummed out. And then you came up and you did this and you were definitely doing some variations I wasn't expecting. And then I was like, did he just hit that? And I looked over, I'm like, he hit that. I was like, and then he did it again. I was like, did he just do that again? I was like, did he do it again? So, The scary part.
Was Jeffrey just nice again?
No.
Yes, he was.
Hey, come on. You guys are killing these people over here. But I will say one thing. By the way, my man, welcome to our show. It's really a pleasure to have you, Bob.
Yeah. I feel so privileged to be sitting with you guys here.
Naval came, and then the nice Jeffrey just came out.
Yeah, that's why he's...
Out of nowhere.
Balance.
True. Yeah.
So you woke me up, but now here's the scary part of what you just did. You've set your own bar here that the next time you perform, if you don't do this well, we're all going to be upset.
Yeah.
We're going to be upset. So for now, though, man, so far, best performance of the evening, my man.
Awesome.
Awesome.
Awesome. No, Shivanand, you got the judges to sit up and listen. Nice job, bro. Have a seat.
Great job. Let's welcome our next contestant, the charming and the handsome Karmchan Sugrum.
Karmchan.
Yeah.
you did a great job. Especially if you were to take all your performances up till now as good, we would, you know, in general, we would definitely compliment you, and which we will. You did do a good job. There were things that I was a little bit concerned about, and I mentioned this to you before. It's like you all have played the game darts before, right? So you go, you look at the thing, and you're always aiming. Most people are always aiming for that center bullseye, and they look at it, and they do whatever they got to do, and they throw, and they aim for the bullseye. What you were doing for some of the parts, right, you were throwing a dart. Let's call your vocal movement or a murki or a harkat. Let's call that your dart. But what was happening is you were closing your eyes and throwing it and hoping that it would hit the bullseye. And now, lucky for you, because God has given you this talent, you hit the bullseye, let's say, 70 to 80% of the time. But that's not how it works. And a lot of times, you know, some of you guys and you as well, every time you do a specific harkat at a spot, it's different every time. And what that tells me is, again, you're playing Russian roulette. And the whole point of it is, yeah, that you should be able to do it different ways, and that's fine, but you should also be able to do it the same way every time. So that's one thing I really want you to think about, because last season, you know, Purnash actually brought this up, and every time I see you, I just feel like you're Vishali with a haircut. I mean, that's kind of bad, but that's also a compliment because she won last year, right?
That's right, exactly.
So I want you to just be careful when you do stuff, because you have this great ability to just do these cool movements with your voice that a lot of people just can't do. But we want you to be careful, especially when you got rude guys like this on the panel that are going to rip you apart.
Oh.
Thank you, Jeffrey. Purnash?
Same thing. I must say, Jeffrey hit it on the money. That's all it was. I feel like the thing is, I could see you think really hard, man. I could see you think really hard. You were not focused throughout this entire performance. You know, don't try to mimic the singer. When you mimic the singer, we know it, because you're not doing what he did. So when you're going, चलना भी है. See, you'll be able to do it every single time. If it's a conscious move, then you hit it every time. Hey. I could do like an exercise. These things you have to surgically work on them. You take them out, dissect them on the table in your mind, and figure it out. That's how it works. And it's okay to simplify. This would have been fine also. This would have been completely fine.
And I also want to emphasize this and actually share this with you. This kid's only 17 years old without any training.
That's amazing.
It's a
17
great thing, man.
Singing like that, oh my God.
That always blows my mind.
That's just amazing. That's just amazing. But that means I expect that much more from you, buddy. You're getting an early start. I want to see your work, all right?
Naval.
Congratulations. You sing with a maturity that is way beyond your years.
Thank you.
And give him a round of applause.
That's a hell of a compliment.
And you definitely demonstrate an agility and flexibility in your voice that I haven't heard for the evening yet. Give him another round of applause, everybody. Saying those things, I also have to point out the issues that I've heard. But I think one major issue for me is that I've observed the panel telling you over and over to simplify it. I've been in the rehearsals where they keep asking you to simplify things, yet you go for these Olympic feats that you are not ready for. You have to learn to take advice from your peers and your seniors. It's the only way you can learn. You have to empty out some of that knowledge from your cup and make room for other people to give you advice and to take it and imbibe it. So let this be the last time that they tell you, simplify it. If you can't do it properly, simplify it. Find another way that will be acceptable and aesthetic at the same time, and you can sincerely sing it from your heart and move people the way that you would want to. I see a lot of myself in you, you know, because we were all at that stage when we were attempting all these difficult passages, but we put in the work in the studio and the practice room, and this is what you have to do. You have to build that relationship with your voice and become intimate with the voice itself. Build an intimacy with it. You have such a beautiful voice and a beautiful instrument. You may just be able to take it. You may just be the Vishali.
What I like about him, though, he's always up for a challenge. And he's one of the most disciplined people in terms of rehearsal. He takes everything on board.
That's
the
true.
Costume.
I've never seen him complain about anything so far.
And that's something that I think is pretty impressive. And if you keep that attitude from age of 17 going forward and stay humble with it, I think you have a far way to go.
Thank you for that, judges. Karam Chan, overall kind words from the judges. You know, let's hope you can take their advice and move forward from there.
Yes, sir.
Vidya Ram is up next.
Oh, Vidya.
When you were starting the song, I'm trying to scare you and I can't. I'm so happy that you sang that so well. That was definitely my favorite performance of yours this far this season.
Jeff, you had me going. You had me going.
And let me tell you what it was. Your feeling was there, and I was so surprised she was hitting the sur. Like she was, you were like right bang center in all like majority of the pitches, and it was just you were in it. And your voice was like, it was even, and you were doing things that I didn't know you could do.
Oh, thanks to Purnaj. Thank you.
I'll leave it short at that. I'm happy.
That really surprised me. You know, the one thing I just told her before she went on stage, I was like, hey, just go all in. Don't worry. Don't be scared to close your eyes and sing. I know they tell you to look at the camera all the time, but it's okay to close your eyes and just sing. And that's what she did. And it was amazing. All the things that we were having trouble with in rehearsal, you missing all those high notes, and it was driving me crazy. I wanted to hang myself. But this time it was good. It was perfect. It was peaceful. It was a very peaceful performance.
Thank you.
And I enjoyed it. Thank you.
Darling, this is why I believe in shows like this. Have you ever sung professionally before, or even semi-professionally in a temple or in a hall or for family and friends? So you do this from time to time?
Yes.
So thanks to this competition, I was able to come here to your country and listen to your beautiful voice and be moved in such a way that all my demons are quiet right now. When I hear good music, it silences me. Just like he said, It made him feel so peaceful. All the time I was feeling the lights, the heat of the lights, your voice was like a cool, fresh breeze that just blew into the area.
Yes.
And calmed us all down.
Thank you.
On your sur, like Jeff said, it wasn't perfect all the time, but it was so beautiful, and the way you balanced your tones, I don't know if you're doing this consciously or not, and throughout the registers, your voice remained present. It remained in the resonance from the lower registers straight up to the higher registers, and it never became jarring to the ear. It was just present in the right amount, present enough to have us all engaged.
Thank you.
Mwah.
Thank you.
Fantastic. Dr. Vindhya.
Oh, adorable.
Enough said.
You stole my heart. You own the song. It was sweetly delivered. I mean, you had me hooked from moment one, and you kept me hooked all through it. I think it was your best performance to date, and whatever you've been doing and whatever you did from the last episode to now, just keep doing it, because it's working all the way through.
It is.
Well done, Vidya.
Up next is Elizabeth Wong.
Well, this is the last performer for the evening, Elizabeth.
Have one problem that keeps coming up every single time. Yeah, you know, I'm gonna start with the good stuff. It was an energetic performance. Your voice is beautiful, it's sweet, and it's got, you know, it's got a lot of range, and it works for this song. It definitely brought the room to life, I thought. Technically, that one thing that keeps popping up every time, whenever it's time for you to hold a long note, it just moves for some reason over and over again. There's no stability there. Like Nivel said earlier, you're not supporting with your diaphragm and keeping that note steady, because you have to have a steady, constant airflow going through your vocal cords to actually sustain those notes. And those things, you guys are not isolating. That's what the training was all about that we did. You know, it was all about breathing and holding these notes and like checking yourself. Whenever we were holding the harmonium, the key down, you just have to match the pitch and make sure it lasts that long. You know, and here, up in the karam ki karada, whenever you, it's going, it's like wavering up and down every single time. And that's the kind of stuff that like, I feel like there's needles poking my every single place. You know, that's what it feels like. I'm sorry, but that's what it feels, because like, I'm expecting, oh. What I mean to say, it was good, but just little technical things, I couldn't enjoy it to the fullest, but it was enjoyable, all right?
Thank you, Pranash.
You know what made up for it? Your confidence at the in those moments. It made me realize that, you know, singing is not just about the voice, it's also how well you can perform. And you are definitely a performer. You just need to work on those things that Pranash G has pointed out to you. And I'm sure the panel has more to say.
Thank you, Nivel.
Although there were a few misses, and some big ones too, in there were some beautiful moments for me. Some truly beautiful moments that touched me. So I want to say, you know, you got it going, girl. Keep it up.
Thank you, Dr. Vindhya.
When you sit on a piano and you hit that note, you 100 times you hit it, it's going to be that, unless there's something wrong with the instrument on that 100th time. But when it comes to the voice, it's all about here. It's all about your ears. And if your body's not with you, you're not going to be able to perform. That's just the sad truth.
So, thank you very much, judges. Yeah. Well, Elizabeth, that's some inspiring words from the judges, you know. So wish you all the best. So that's the end of our scheduled performances for tonight. Up next, we've got a little surprise, and yes, the most dreaded part of the night, the eliminations. Stay tuned for Emerging Voices when we get back.
Excuse me, ladies. Girl, something smells good in that kitchen. Now, I don't know about the rest of you, but I gonna find out why it's for your secret to a legendary curry chicken.
You're waiting for me. Mm-hmm. Can I help you, girl?
Girl, you know Linda Fass. She's wondering what makes your curry the most talked about in town.
It's no secret, ladies. It's Sujata.
Oh, Sujata.
I found our colors.
Torgonal's state-of-the-art color matching system accurately matches any color sample you need to your satisfaction, making your color choices unlimited.
We finally made our decision.
Great, let's get started.
Something else.
Visit Torgonal at 118 Regent and Alexander Streets or 21 Regent and Hing Streets.
Hi, I'm Chelsea Edgel, your National Honor 21 and Women's Champion 2016. And when I'm off the court, I drink the juice of champions, Sunburst.
Sunburst Juice is manufactured by Continental Foods Inc.
Orange Box, extra, extra, hear all about it. E-Network's Orange Box, everyone is trying to find out about it. 10 free channels, pay one time. No, no monthly fees, ain't that sublime? Movies, sports, everything you need. So maximize your cable life with E-Network's Orange Box. Everybody wants that brand new Orange Box.
The Orange Box is back in stock. Pick it up at Star Computer, Gizmos and Gadgets, NP Electronics, and the Electronic City today.
Welcome back to Emerging Voices Season 2. I'm Jared, this is Taruna. Now, I've got some big news for you guys. I just got some information from backstage. We've got a massive surprise in store for you.
After being eliminated from E-Network's Emerging Voices, I was a bit disappointed and dejected because I had really high hopes from this competition, and I had plenty of supporters, and they were disappointed as well. But my dad, he was really heartbroken. He actually said that it was actually the first time actually that he came to see me perform live, like physically present there. He never really came to my graduation, although I did so well at CXC. And this is like the first time he came out to support me in something, and I was let down. I was eliminated from the competition, and that really took it, he took it really hard, and he said that he's probably my bad luck charm or something like that. So that really broke my heart. Well, the news about the wildcard entry came when I was at home. I got a call from Purnar sir. I was really totally excited. I didn't expect they would have called me back, but I'm really thankful that he did. A second chance means a lot to me, and I think I'm here with my A-game. I'll be there with my A-game, so you guys just beware.
Back, Parmeshwari.
Welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling lucky.
You've been given a second chance at superstardom.
I know. That's why I'm lucky. I feel lucky.
And do you think you made the most of it tonight? I mean, I heard the crowd go crazy when you finished your performance. Do you think you hit it out of the park?
I did try my best, so.
Let's hear what the judges think about it. Judges, how do you think she did tonight?
As a song choice, that was a terrific song choice for a comeback. As a performance, I have to say, maybe I expected more. And Jeffrey always gets worried when I say I love songs, because then I expect so much from that song or from the singer.
That was one of your
personal
favorites.
My advice is always never sing a song that Dr. Vindi loves, because she will never love it unless that original singer is singing it. Or unless they sing it just as well or better.
Tough choice. No. I'm not putting that kind of pressure on you, but but I just felt that a lot of it was flat to me, the very end of the song. There were moments there that I thought should have been earlier, that you held it and you managed to get it. But there were too many moments when I didn't think that you brought it. Like, I mean, it's such a beautiful song. It should be the kind of song that says Parmeshwari is back.
Right.
And I just wanted more from it.
Pranash.
The Parmeshwari.
Yes,
I'm happy to see you back. And
thank
your
you.
Voice sounds better. I know you're still a little sick. I know you're a little sick, but it sounds better. The performance was really chill. It was too chill. That's the problem. You know, it's a love song, and there's some degree to pain of pain in there, you know? I feel like I didn't feel that. I couldn't feel it too much. But it was sweet. It was sweet and like airy, you know. But you missed a few things there in the verse, but I felt, you know, given the situation, I felt you sounded good, and I know you're trying your best. And I feel like the things that are required for you to like make this song fly is a little like an advanced kind of thing, because these are things that you learn and you read while you're singing the song. Like after the first part of the song, you should realize, hey, this pattern is starting to sound repetitive, and maybe it's up to me to make it fly, you know? And that's something you're supposed to like think about earlier, and you know, bring it in the second verse, bring it in the last chorus. So, good job.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pranash. Nival?
I think that the fact that you were thrown a lifeline means that the judges did see some sort of star potential in you. And I certainly see it myself. But it needs a lot of development. And you have to take into consideration all the vocal issues that they expressed and keep working on that voice, darling. You definitely have something special.
Thank you.
Earlier in the competition, she was here and she was doing well. And the day you were eliminated, your voice just wasn't with you. It really, I mean, I felt really bad about it. We all did. Even the band said stuff about it. And it was like, we were excited for you to come back and really kind of blow us away. And I'm really disappointed that that didn't happen.
Well, you know, I thought it was an inspired performance. Always good to have you.
Thank you.
Emerging Voices is something special. And, you know, Nimal said it earlier that this set, this production, what we're doing here is something that's, you know, some of the highest production value and highest class that we're trying
that.
To bring.
I mean, the region. I mean, that's
yeah, in the region, exactly. Yeah. And that's exactly what our focus has been here at Emerging Voices as a team, is to take this competition. Obviously, the home of this competition, you know, is Guyana. But what we're trying to do is we're promoting music. We're promoting our Indian roots. We're promoting the beauty of what we have. And it's only, I think, the best thing to do for our community is to take it beyond borders. It's to take it multinational. It's to take it international. It's to take it to all of the countries and really make this more about a beautiful experience for Caribbean people and the diaspora. So I think that it's... It was a bit of a an interesting, you know, idea and thought, and I'm really, really excited at the fact that we at Emerging Voices are keeping an open mind and trying to take this competition to a whole nother level because this is not a one or two trick pony or one, two season type of show. We are taking this on and on and on, and we want this thing to blow up. And we want this thing to be international, like I said. We want people from New York. We want people from Canada. We want people from Trinidad. We want people from Suriname. We want people from the Netherlands. Whoever we can get that has this, it is that diaspora, that Caribbean vibe. We're really trying to bring that. We're trying to showcase these folks. We're trying to make opportunities for these folks. We're trying to bring training to these folks. And this next surprise is not someone from Guyana. This someone from another country, because we, with our efforts, are trying to bring more, and we're trying to make this show something better. And we're trying to encourage people from Trinidad and Suriname and Canada that have these connections, that have these roots, to come and be a part of this show, to come and try out for the show. And this next performer that we have is someone that we found from Trinidad. She will be performing as a wild card today. And
second wild card.
Yep, we have a second wild card.
Nice.
And we are looking forward to welcoming her here to Emerging Voices, welcoming her to Guyana. And I am very, very, very excited to hear what she's got to give us.
I come from a musical background where my parents were singers, my uncles, my aunts, they were all singers. So I grew up in a musical family. However, I started singing in school. My name is Savita Singh, and I am from Trinidad and Tobago. I'm happy to be here in Guyana. It's not my first time though. I really, really like the curry here, so I think it's the curry that keeps me coming back. I am 30 years old. Do I look like 30? I hope not. I am a really fun-going person. I like to laugh a lot. I like to make a lot of jokes out of everything that's not supposed to be joking about. But yeah, that's my personality. Just like Carnival back home, you know, colorful personality. I looked at the 2014 season and I was blown away by the artists, by the singers, by the judges, by the type of show. I never thought that it actually had a show like this out of India. And I was really amazed that it was happening right here in Guyana. Not only was I blown away by that, but actually the judges, they were not just there to judge. They were also there to help you. I'm here to do my very best. I'm here for the experience, and I'm here to definitely make new friends, hoping to make it to the final five. We are all winners in our very own way, so good luck again. Aap jaisa koi meri zindagi mein aaye to baat ban jaye.
A warm Guyanese welcome for Miss Savita Singh.
Hello.
How are you?
Fine, thank you. And you?
Great to have you on the show.
Thank
How are you
very
doing?
Much. A bit nervous, excited, but happy at the same time to be here.
Not your first time in Guyana?
No.
Second time?
Like about the 15th time.
The 15th time.
Oh, wow.
So you're almost Guyanese practically, no? Yeah, I would say that. So Savita, real quick, what do you think of the Guyanese competition here tonight?
I've been only listening them to the back, but so far...
From what you've heard?
From what I've heard, they're all awesome. Really, really nice.
Fantastic.
I'm excited to meet them.
I'm ready to hear your performance. Do your thing.
Best wishes, Savita. Thank you very
much. Warm welcome.
जग घूम आ थारे जैसा
First, to give you a Guyanese welcome. It's so refreshing hearing a new voice on the show, a different texture. I feel like your performance was effortless. I know you were a little nervous. It's kind of like unfair, you know. It's in a way because you have to join the competition here under all this pressure. It's weird, like you're the new person, and you dealt with it like a champ. You know, the song you gave the song the exact amount of effort it needed. You didn't give it more, you didn't give it less, it was just enough effort, and it definitely had wings, and it sounded beautiful, sweet. It's, you know, a few things there, and the endings, but hey, other than that, the rest was awesome.
Thank you.
When you started singing there, it was a little bit shaky, it was a little bit pitchy in the beginning, because you were looking for your foothold, but then, once you got secure in the song and in the melody, you started expressing yourself in such an emotive way that I have not even seen before. I've seen you perform in Trinidad and Tobago, and I don't know if it's because you're on Guyanese soil, because it happens to me too.
That is exactly
the energy and the love and the vibration of Guyana gives us this ability to sing with so much more emotions and feelings. Thank you for doing that, Guyana. I've never seen Savita emote so much and pour so much of her heart into a song. And it really enabled you to flourish and make beautiful lines and beautiful phrases with the music. Again, I was looking for, you know, when you go up in the upper register and your voice just flourishes in a way that slays us all. I was waiting for that. But this challenge that Purnash threw out to you kept you in that lower register and you handled it like a vocal soldier. You just hammered every phrase, you hammered all your landings, and all the beautiful runs you did with your voice, they were very secure. They were secure enough for me to say, awesome, thumbs up.
Thank you very much. Neville. Thank you.
Well done. I thoroughly enjoyed it, and I want to hear you on more, and I think you coming on the show just raises the visibility of the show that much more. Because if we can have a Surinamese or people from anywhere else, basically, it means that many people are looking at the show and are interested in it because someone's from their country now. And I also want to say to the Guyanese on the stage, look at it as competition, take it in good spirit, and you know what? Represent Guyana, all right? All
Thank
right,
you, Dr.
represent
Vindia.
Guyana, because she represented Trinidad, and we want to see the competition as a healthy one, and I want that team spirit to be amongst all of you going forward. But never, never get comfortable. That's what this is all about. It shakes your comfort level up, yeah, and it pushes you to do that much more work, mm-hmm, and this is where the competition is. Very nice job, Savita.
Thank you, Dr.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Iqbal, your thoughts?
The fact that you're nervous makes me, because obviously I have a relationship with these guys, right? So I'm kind of like in their corner. But at the same time, when I see someone who's just so open-minded, open-hearted, and very kind of, just kind of honest, it feels. I mean, I don't know you that well, but I feel that. And it was kind of confirmed when you sang. It was interesting, because when you started, first thing I noticed, love the tone of your voice. I love the fact that when you were, it was just so much, the word sukoon came. It was like this very peaceful kind of vibe. And when you were on that, you know, in that lower register, it was just velvet. And then there was a point where you kind of came out your shell for a second, and then you went back in. And the moment you came out, it's like your eyes kind of lit up.
And then he looked at the camera, and I was like, oh, snap, she's about to work the camera. And you just kept on doing things. And I think I haven't had this kind of reaction yet. And these guys are doing really, really well. So don't get too nervous. I'm actually just excited to hear what else you have. And I hope that this wasn't your, like, one lucky performance, right? I'm going to keep you a little bit, and I'm going to keep your nerves on. I want to see you grow. I want to see you keep on performing. There were obviously, yeah, there were, like these guys mentioned, there were like 3-4 spots where you kind of lost it. But welcome to the show. And I'm excited to hear what you're going to sing next.
Thank you very much for that, Jeffrey. Taruna, it's been a night of unexpected twists and turns.
Right.
But up next is the elimination round. Find out if your favorite is going home when Emerging Voices Season 2 returns. We'll be right back.
Good in that kitchen. Now, I don't know about the rest of you, but I going to find out what is for your secret to a legendary curry chicken.
You're waiting for me. Mm-hmm. Can I help you, girl?
Girl, you know Linda Fass. She wondering what makes your curry the most talked about in town.
It's no secret, ladies. It's Sujata.
Oh, Sujata.
Hi, Giano. I'm Danny, the national badminton champion. When I'm off the court, I drink the juice of champions. Sunburst.
Sunburst juice, available in 9 great flavors, manufactured by Continental Foods, Inc., and available at all supermarkets, wholesale depot, and retail outlets nationwide.
Welcome back to Emerging Voices Season 2. We're about to enter into the elimination round. Now, those of you watching at home may remember how this works. Two persons will be eliminated from the competition based on the number of likes that they're given from the judges. Judges, over to you for your decision.
So, there were some top performers who won our hearts and our likes. And the performer who got the most likes from all of the judges and who is the performer of the day is, any guesses?
Shivanan.
Yeah? Final answer?
I think so.
Maybe we bring them all on stage, yeah?
Shivanand, Tarun is taking all the credit for whatever you did, so you better keep her as your lucky charm, because it was good tonight. But I have to say, you did well, but you weren't our top performer. Ooh. You came in as number 2. The person who gained the most likes, in fact, the most likes that we've ever given on any of the episodes is Vidya Ram. You're the top performer of the day. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Vidya. You are safe.
You are safe. So now, it comes down to who scored third and fourth. And yes, you are right, Dharmraj, to be looking out for your competitors. Because coming in at number 3, very strong, a good first impression, Savita. Congratulations, you're safe.
Savita. You're also safe.
You are number 3. Congratulations. the boy who has all the moves and who has his eye on all the girls, and he's constantly pulling. And who's constantly pulling surprises out of every performance. Congratulations, you would say.
Great job, buddy.
Well done, Karthik.
To the point we have all been waiting for, to the moment that, you know, comes. This is hard because I've always liked the voice of the person I'm gonna have to say so long to tonight. I've always felt that he brought positive energy. I've always felt that he has a very unique voice, and his voice lends to a lot of different things. But tonight, for some reason, he just did not do it as well as he should. But I want to say to him, because you have such a love for what you're doing, and it's so apparent when you perform, I just want to say, keep on singing and sharing the gift of your voice with everyone. And that person is Ritesh. Tonight we bid you farewell, but we don't say goodbye to singing forever. Keep on singing. I love your voice.
Best of luck to you, sir.
Thanks so much. Appreciate it. I am Ritesh Tularam. I'm all the way from Nambrel, the east coast of Demerara. And I must say I'm very, very privileged and happy to be a part of this E-Networks Season 2.
Dekh, dekh, sona, tujh dekh kar hai jagna.
You think we should take your daddy to the next level?
That will be a yes.
That's awesome. I think we're going to have to listen to the boss.
I think that you brought the Ritesh energy that I've always enjoyed. You had confidence, it had soul.
So judges, that's one down, three contestants remaining. Who gets the axe next?
So Jeffrey's backing out. Vidya did one for me. And my brother from another auntie is backing out too, but that's what it is. We wanted to do whatever we can to make this competition fair. You know, when you're eliminated, you're eliminated. That's all. But we wanted to make it fair. And the performer who I'm calling, you did your best. You worked hard. I know you've worked hard. And you did your best, and we wanted to give you a second chance. So, Elizabeth, you're safe.
Elizabeth, you can have a seat with the rest of the contestants. You move on to the next round.
So, Dharmaraj, you, sir, have been a performer for quite some time. You've learned a little bit. I know you've been involved in a lot of religious music, and now you're venturing out to learning new different songs, and so far you've been handling them quite well. Not all the way there, but quite well. But you're definitely a strong contestant here. So, Parmeshwari, it's so great to hear your voice. You know, I missed your voice. I didn't get to hear it at all, and I really wanted to hear it. I really wanted to give you a chance. But, you know, like everybody said, we gotta be fair. I wanted to give you a second chance. We all wanted to give you a second chance. And we feel like you really didn't bring your all. And I really wanted you to prove yourself, and I was really hoping that you would hit it. So today, your journey ends on this show. All right, thank you so much for sharing your voice with us. I love your personality, I love your spirit. I want you to keep it up. Never stop singing, because when you love something, no setback can turn you away. No setback can turn you away, because you're going to always keep coming back every single time. So keep bringing it back, keep working hard, keep singing. That's all. Okay?
Well, I'd say all of my voice is not back as yet, so I'm totally fine. I'm really glad that I had a second chance. I felt really lucky. And I'm glad the guys, they were actually welcoming me instead of, you know, oh my God, why is she coming back? So I'm really grateful that I had a second chance. I think I could have done better, but it was a, like, 50-50 performance. I felt it, and I know you guys felt it as well. So I'm really grateful, and to the contestants, all the best. Thank you.
We love your spirit. Great spirit. We love having you on the show. All the best to you. You know, Taruna, I think we promised an epic episode, and I think we delivered on an epic
episode. Certainly we did.
Six contestants remain to compete next week. Tune in next week to find out if your favorite gets eliminated or if they take the next step in the journey to becoming this year's emerging voice. That's all for tonight. Thank you and good night.
रवि नटन नन नग लगाने आई हवन ठन गोली चल गई धाय नगर विलती इगो मेरती नगर विलती इगो मेरती टशन दिखाती फुल अर लड़की ब्यूटी फुल कर गई चुल
kind of story that will inspire many women to take charge of their lives.
Chaudhvi ka chand ho ya aftab ho jo bhi ho tum khuda ki qasam lajawab ho
Gita, I love you.
I love you too.